Hello and welcome to another episode of Euro Truck Simulator. Today we're taking what looks like some sort of water tank, sewage tank, something like that, down to Cambridge. So we're just going to jump into our truck and start up the engine and see how we go. Let's get the sat nav set up. Oh, we don't want that button. And get our wing mirrors back. And we're gonna head off. So we've got a daytime drive ahead of us. It's currently 6:15 in the morning, so nice early start. Just gonna head off out of the builder's yard here. See what we can find along the way. So if you've been following the series, we're still at newbie level. Trying to progress. Traffic today. Hurricane coming up there. A little bit of a pickle here because we then need to go right here at the roundabout. Good. That means he's going to let us go. That means he's going to let us go. That's very handy. Just check that no traffic coming here. Yep, we're all clear. And away we go. Yep, seems a bit busier this morning. There's a lot of people going off to work this time in the morning. Right on the roundabout here. Traffic coming, which is good. Ooh. Do you see that guy behind us? Sure whose fault that was. I'm not sure if we touched him or not. He was coming around there way too fast. Okay, so just wait for the lights to go green. And then we'll be on our way. So we're travelling down to Cambridge today. Somewhere that we haven't discovered. Interesting, slightly different journey. It's about a 2 hour drive, so shouldn't be too bad. We've been given a nice Mercedes truck to drive today. Looks pretty cool. Feel too underpowered at the moment. That little bit of hill seemed alright. Speed up now. Gonna head off left at the top here. Take us towards London, Cambridge. Some of these lane changes are, they come up on you quite quick. So you're not always instantly aware of where you're supposed to be turning. They seem to drop down quite often from 3 to 2, sometimes down to 1 lane, which can be a little bit confusing. Now on the M6, heading down south, and it started to rain. It's always good. On. Okay, so I think soon we're going to be ready to buy our own truck. We've got 20,000 euros. That's a pretty good deposit, I would have thought. Once we finish this, we should be up to about 24,000 euros. So I think we're very close to being able to buy a truck. It's just deciding which one to get, which one's got the best all-round abilities for a beginner. See where you're going in this rain. Don't think, no, we don't. Over there. Yeah, so you get this funny little third lane here. I don't know why anyone would use that lane. This truck is definitely more powerful. I think the cargo's not that heavy on the back. But saying that, this truck feels much better than those previous trucks. I'm not sure what he's doing in that lane over there. This is a bit of a miserable day out there. It'll brighten up a bit by the time we get down to Cambridge. Thunder and lightning as well now. Sure, I think everyone else is driving slower because of the weather conditions. I don't think you normally get this van going quite this slow. Just gonna take him. Get a little bit close to him there. The side swipe. The A14. Again, a fairly easy journey here, straight road ahead. Yeah, I'm looking forward to when we can start driving actually around Europe. So So far we've only travelled in the UK. Interesting to see how the game differs in Europe. Busy coming out of Birmingham, but it's so busy here. Oh, it's going slow in. That's annoying because he slows down on a hill and it takes me forever to get going again. Again, towards Cambridge still. This guy, oh, overtake. Yeah, I'm not, steering is done by G25 wheel, Logitech G25 wheel, and sometimes the steering's quite loose. So sometimes you do a small turn and it turns a lot more than you think, so I'm not sure if I've just got the wrong setup or something, but occasionally I'll drift a little bit. It's probably just my bad driving on the steering wheel. Service is in, the rain seems to be easing off. A little bit out there. It'll be interesting to see what the drop point is for this cargo, because it's slightly different from the ones we've taken so far. There's a bit of a challenge involved. Junction. Get away. Looks like it's all clear. Sunflowers again. I wonder if we get to deliver them at some point. Okay, so we can see our drop point on the map. Seems to be coming into Cambridge. Chill speed through here. They've put a speed camera right where the speed limit changes. Hey, Cambridge discovered. It's always good to discover a new place. Wonder if we're turning down here, I think. Yeah, we'll just hold those cars up behind us. Nice little road, factory there. you do. Here we are at E Acres. Just gonna stop up here. And request our parking space. Well, this one's 90 XP. It's gonna be tricky, I bet. Let's go for it, see how we do. I click that, we'll click confirm, and I can see it over there in the corner. Look, well, that's not too bad. Should be able to do this. Looks like a bit of a farm here. So we'll swing this round again. And the key with this is to get your truck and trailer as straight as possible before you start going backwards. We've got plenty of space here to manoeuvre. Good, so that looks good. Let's put it into reverse. And let's just slowly back. There's another trailer on the other side of us there. We want to try and avoid that fence if we can. Here a little bit. A little bit more. Looking good so far. To take it around a bit. Can we do it in one attempt? Do this in one attempt. That's looking good. Not quite sure if it's gonna go green though. Nope, that's annoying. Obviously, not quite as good as I'd hoped. Not easy to see that fence there. We've just gone back exactly the same position we were before. Let's try that. I think you have to have your truck in that space as well, which isn't great. Let's get this back into first gear. It's going to be easy, but it's not proving quite as easy as I'd hoped. I think we've gone far too wide there. Did I hit that fence? We might be alright. Can't actually see where this trailer's now going. No, I think we're going way off here. Let's go forward a bit. Sorry, this always takes me a lot longer than it should. I haven't mastered the art of parking yet. If anyone has any recommendations on how park, then that would be greatly appreciated. We've got it now. This is looking slightly better. That's it, the back wheel's going in now. Let me just straighten this up. Hopefully. That's it. Cool. So we detach the trailer, decoupling, and we're done. Distance driven 120 miles, time taken 3 hours and 4 minutes, fuel consumed 96.8. That still keeps us on level 3, still a newbie. I don't think we've got many. 284 XP, so not bad, not bad. Still some way to go though before level 4. Once again, thanks for watching and look forward to seeing you again in the next episode. Take care, bye.